दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 1 अंडरस्टैंडिंग डिवर्सिटी। डिवर्सिटी और विविधता, व्हाट डज इट मीन? व्हेनेवर यू आर इन अ क्लास एंड यू सी योर फ्रेंड्स, दे ऑल लुक डिफरेंट, दे ऑल आर डिफरेंट इन देयर थॉट्स, देयर बैकग्राउंड्स। सो ऑल दीज पीपल हु you see in your neighborhood or wherever you go in train or aircraft or wherever in the market, you'll see different kind of people wearing different dresses, having different religious background, cultures. And this is the diversity, and this diversity makes this world and our country a unique place to live. So if all students in your class are being asked the same question, same set of questions, and it is highly unlikely that all of you give the same answer, just because the general question may have different thoughts, may have different answers. So in many ways you are quite like some of your classmates, your students, fellow students, but in many ways you are different from them. So how do you make your friends? You might be having some best friends or good friends. So how does it go like that? Now I'll tell you a story of this traffic signal. So here is a kid and he sells newspaper. There is one more person who is on this bicycle, and they happen to become friends. And whenever this traffic light goes red, they talk. And whenever it goes green, they just part away. And slowly and gradually, they become friends. Now this guy or this person asks him, okay, you want this Hindi newspaper? Oh, I'm surprised. But this, he says, what? Don't you think I know Hindi also? So he was surprised. Like this, there, you can say friendship started. And one time he said one, because they were discussing about schooling, etc. And he talked about subjects. The way he uttered that word subjects, he thought that this subjects he is talking about is about the emperor or a king talking about their subjects of praja or people whom this emperor rule. Now all these things are happening, and one day they came to know each other, and he said, my name is Samir, and he also said, my name is Samir too. So they just laughed together, and this newspaper seller, he said, okay, now you are Samir 1 from now, and I am Samir 2. He also said that he started selling newspaper when he was, and he actually went to this bike and showed that what was his height when he started selling the newspaper. And he said that his mother also accompanied him to sell these newspaper, but now she doesn't come and she has shifted to Meerut. So all these things are happening because they just meet for a short time whenever the signal is red. One day he was very dejected and very concerned. So now they are now friends. So he asked, Samir 1 asked, what happened? Why are you feeling low? And Samir 2 said that I heard about the communal riots at Meerut, and I'm very disturbed because all of my family is there. And now he Samir 1 came to know that Samir 2 is a Muslim. And before that, they were talking. And Samir 1 happened to be a Hindu. But still, they continued talking and they were friends. Knowing that they have different backgrounds, knowing that they have, you know, very least thing in common. But still, they made friends. And the next day, when this person, Samir 1, came, Samir too was nowhere to be found because he might have left for Meerut. So what we saw in this story is Samir 1 is familiar with English. Samir 2, he doesn't speak English. He can speak Hindi because though they don't have very much common, but they still wanted to speak and they actually talk. Samir 1 and Samir 2, they have different religions. One was Hindu, one was Muslim. And also because of this religious and cultural backgrounds, they still talk. And this religious background and culture and the language, all this comes under diversity. Okay, now you understood what is diversity. Diversity is what they speak, what is their background, what is their history, what is their culture. All these are the diversification of these two individuals. Samir 1, he goes to school, but is Samir 2, he didn't get chance to go to the school. Now, apart from these two, you generally, if you go to some slum area or nearby area, you will find people like him. These people are poor. Poor, they don't have roti, kapda, makan. They don't have enough to eat. They don't have enough to wear. They don't even have shelter. And in India only, we have Ambanis and Adanis. Ambani, in entire world, top 10 richest people, Ambani is one of them. That is, India is the poor country of rich people. Means you have rich people or rich country of poor people, you can say. So this is not diversity. See, these two are not diverse. They just don't have, he has had resources because his father, Dhirubhai Ambani, he was a very poor guy, or you can say a trader, but he did a lot, he suffered a lot, and he actually made his fortune. And now Ambani, both the Ambanis, Mukesh Ambani and Anil Ambani, they are having enough money. And enough money, they rule the world actually. Anil Ambani ruled the world. So what we see here, that he had resources, but this guy has no resources, not even the basic need. So this is not diversity. Diversity, they don't have, he didn't get the opportunity, he grabbed the opportunity. So this will not come under diversity, right? This is just that the opportunity problem is there, or you can say that this is a situation of inequality. It is not diversity. Okay, now one more situation is there. There is a black mark on our Indian head. What is that? That is called caste system. Caste system. So in this caste system, it was earlier, you know, followed because of various reason, and still various people have these things in their mind, but young like you and me, we don't have. So what was the caste system? That in the on the topmost ladder of people were Brahmins, they were priests and academics. Then comes the Kshatriyas, they were rulers, they save the land, they protect the land, administrate as warriors. Vaishyas were mainly traders, tradesmen. So artisan, farmers, merchants, they were Vaishya. And finally, the Shudra. And Shudra comes where? See the position. Brahmins are on the head and Shudras here. These were manual labors. And there were Ati Shudras also. These are called Dalits, untouchables, Achut, street cleaners. And shall I say that that the excreta, human waste, the janwar or the animals who die, they take them, and they are achut. They are called achut. So this is not a diversity. This is not an example of diversity, because see, if a person is a potter, it was forced by the society that the kid of the family will also become a potter. He cannot take any other job, and this was forcefulness of the society. So this is not diversity, this was forcefulness, and this was also an example of inequality. So this is not diversity. I hope you understand the diversity and inequality difference. Now I'll tell you or I'll ask you to see this picture. This picture is quite good, but it's only black and white. So what will happen? Because God has given us a very colorful world, colorful people. So if you are being told a story in which only background, only, you know, black and white is there, or a story in which there are only two animals, or a story, or if you eat only two food all over your life, so you don't have flavors, you don't have different colors, you don't have different diversification, what will happen? You know, you can understand that you will not be able to live properly or the way you should live. So this diversity is very important. And whenever we talk about diversity in India, we have different religion. And these religion, you know, they follow their culture, their religious, whatever sayings are there. But you tell me that, is there any religion which says don't say truth? Is there any religion which says kill people? Is there any religion which says that do burglary? There is no religion. Every religion says only one thing: respect, love, humanity, and take care of the poor. This is all religions say. So this diversity, you know, when we do many things that are similar, except that we do them in different ways. So how do we explain this diversity? How this diversity happened? Say if a Hindu marries a Muslim, now there will be a kid. Now this kid is half Hindu, half Muslim. And if you remember that they have different cultures. Now this kid will have a Hindu culture also and a Muslim culture also. And he will start respecting both the religions. This is how diversification has happened. And long back, you know, there were no aircraft, there were no trains. So people used to go travel from one place to another by horses, camels and food. And why? What was the reason? First reason, they want to settle, they want to trade, so for tradesmanship they want to go to other place, or they may have some other situation like the drought, or say, you know, famines. So if there is nothing to eat, people are forced to leave their place. And sometimes war. In Syria, the war is so dangerous that most of the Syrians, they have fled or left the country, or they are living in the nearby Turkish and Jordanian the boundary as refugees. And Syria was one of the famous country. You know, Damascus was one of the beautiful place, but now because of war, this city is finished. Okay. Now what will happen? That whenever these people mix together, as I just said, this is the migration taking place. So whenever people meet, different people meet, and when they form a family or a neighborhood, they exchange the ideas, they exchange the cultures, they exchange the food, and that is the intermixing of cultures. As I said, that Hindu, Muslim, or say a Christian and a Buddhist, they get married. What will happen? Their culture will get intermixed. So in India, we have no Muslims. We have Indian Muslims. In India, we don't have Sanatans. We have Hindus. Because Hindus have taken all the good things from all other cultures. Muslims have taken all good things from all cultures which are in India. So we have a very varied culture, but a strong unity among us. Now, one more thing, let me ask you a question. What do you think? A person living here and a person living here, do they have same way of eating, same manner they eat, or whatever they wear, is that same? Remember, Ladakh and Kerala, they both are in the same country, India. But I'll show you that how varied they are, how different the cultures are. And just because this is a different region, the distance from the sea, the neighbors, etc., all these, and the people who have come here in the past, they all make the living or the diversification of any place different from other. So let us take an example. Let us understand about Ladakh and Leh. And not only people have different, as I said, eating and clothing habits, they do work differently also. That is, just take an example of a gaon or a village. So in village, people grow their own food. Normally, they grow. But if you talk about urban area, say Delhi, you will not find people growing their own food. They will be dependent on the people who are growing food, okay, or making other things like manufacturing, etc. So as I said, let us discuss about Kerala and Ladakh, and whatever I am telling about Kerala and Ladakh, you have to understand with the perspective that I am talking about the diversity or diversification, okay. Ladakh is at the topmost place of India. Here, actually, this is Ladakh. I'll show you that what territory we have. So this place is Gilgit-Baluchistan. This is with Pakistan. This is Aksai Chin, and this is with China. Here we have Ladakh, and here we have this as Leh. So we have Leh as the capital of Ladakh. Now it's in the eastern part of this Kashmir, Jammu Kashmir, and Jammu Kashmir was a state until 2019, prior to August 2019. But the Indian government, the BJP government, they have changed the status of Jammu Kashmir government from state to union territory. Now we have Jammu Kashmir as union territory and Ladakh also as union territory. Both were states earlier, but now they are union territories. So Ladakh is a desert, but it is a cold desert. Ladakh is a cold desert. So it's in the eastern part of Jammu and Kashmir, and very little agriculture is possible here because it doesn't get so much of rain. Almost it is covered by snow, and there are very few trees, if you can see here, very few trees that can grow in this region. And wherever the snow, it melts, then only they get the drinking water. So the drinking water is also scarce. Okay. Now people here keep sheep, and the sheep in this region are called, they are special because they produce pashmina. So these are the type of sheep and goats they have. So they have pashmina shawls, pashmina wool, and with this wool they make pashmina shawls. And this pashmina shawl are very expensive. They are very expensive because they make it, they sell it to the traders in Jammu Kashmir, and Jammu Kashmir gets, you know, more these salani or tourism than this Ladakh. So mostly pashmina shawl are being sold here. And people here, they eat milk and meat. And meat is very important because it's very cold area. And they also eat cheese and butter. And each family have their goats. They have their zoos, that is yak cows. And being, this is a yak. And being a desert did not mean Ladakh did not attract traders. It was considered a good trade route. They have various darras here, various passes. And this route from these passes, various caravans travel to which is today called the Tibet. This is a Tibet. This is a Tibet area. And this Tibet area, from here, people came to trade like silk and carpets, etc. From here only, the place I told you, because, you know, we have Jammu Kashmir, which is a Muslim, mostly Muslim area, Kashmir, not Jammu. And Tibet is a Buddhist area. So Ladakh has a blend of Islam and Buddhism. So Islam was introduced in this region more than 400 years ago, and we have a very significant Muslim population here. And Ladakh has a very, very rich oral tradition of songs and poem. So the local versions of the Tibetan national epic, the Kesar Saga, are performed, sung by both the Muslims and the Buddhists. Few more things here is that camel with one hump is found normally in the Marusthal area or desert area of India. But when you go to this place, you will get twin humped. That is like this, twin humped camels. There is a mystical magnetic hill. where you will see that car is going in the opposite direction. That is, it is climbing the elevation by itself. The Ladakhs, we have Kung Fu nuns, nuns which learn Kung Fu. Highest residential point in Ladakh. So, Ladakh is the highest residential point where people live in India, served by River Indus. And we have Indian Astronomy Center because of the high altitude and clear skies. Ladakh is one of the places in which India considered as an this important astronomy center is there. And we have great diversity of birds. 225 different species of birds have been recorded till date in Ladakh. We have So Muriri. This is not only a wetland conservative reserve, but also one of the largest, highest altitude lakes in India. And the lake we are talking about is Pangong Lake. Around 45 kilometers is with us, and 95 kilometers is with the China. So this is the highest salt lake in India. It is situated at the height of about 14,270 feet from sea level, and it is 134 kilometer long and extends from India to Tibet, that is the Chinese place. Kerala is the state or the place of God, and here this is Kerala. Now, why this Kerala is important? Because of the diversity also, and because of the best state in India. Why it is, you will just know. First, that Kerala is the state in the southwest corner of India here, and it is surrounded by the sea on one side here, and then we have the mountain here. Let me show you that here we have the sea, which is the Arabian Sea, and below also we have the Indian Ocean, and here we have the mountains. Here we have mountains, and in these mountains we find very good quality of spices. The pepper, long, cloves, the kalimish, the cardamoms, the lychee, these are grown in these hills. And it is spices that make this region an attractive place for traders. So when we go back, Jewish, Yahudi and Arabs, these traders were first to come here. It is also assumed that the apostle, the dude of Christ, Saint Thomas, is believed to have come here nearly 2000 years ago. And he is credited with bringing the Christianity in India. Many Arab traders also came here, settled down here. Ibn Battuta, who traveled here a little less than 700 years ago, wrote a travelogue in which he describes the Muslim culture here and Muslim life here, Muslim community. The Portuguese discovered the sea route to India from Europe when Vasco da Gama landed with his ship here. And because of all these various historical influences, people in Kerala, they practice different religion. So we have Judaism, we have Islam, we have Christianity, we have Hinduism, we have Buddhism here. And because of this different culture, different religion, people live here with harmony. You don't find any communal riots here, as you see in UP and Bihar, etc. You don't find it here. People are so lovely, so loving, and they are best people. Here you see Olam. Olam is the most popular festival here. And then you see various people when came here, like Chinese and others, especially Chinese, you see, there are fishing nets, and these are the fishing nets, and these are called the China wala. Even the utensils used for frying is called China chatti. This is called China chatti, and these both have Chin name in them, Chin, China. This land is very fertile because, you know, first June, India gets its monsoon entered from Kerala only, and because of this very fertile land, the climate is suited for growing rice, and majority of people here eat rice and fish and vegetables. So Wayanad is a place where Rajiv Gandhi is the MP. There are other places, Anfazu, that is, you know, LFP we call it. We have very beautiful black backwaters here. Then Trivandrum is the capital of Kerala. So God's own country is Kerala. If you happen to, you know, go somewhere for your time, just go to Kerala. Why Kerala is so good? It has highest human development index, 0.79. Highest sex ratio, women are more than men. We have matriarchal, society here. Highest life expectancy of 77 years. Least corrupted Indian state. The capital is Thiruvananthapuram. Previously it was called Trivandrum. Official language is Malayalam. We have very great stars like Mammootty here. Population is around 3.4 crores. Literacy rate, let me change it. It's 99%+ literacy rate is there. That is why this state is talked about everywhere in the world. The area is around 38,000 square kilometer. So this Kerala and Ladakh, we have seen, they have different geographical features. People came here from different countries and now they have influence of Chinese and Arab traders. So what we see, unity in diversity, that when Britishers rule us for more than 200 years, but still when we wanted them to leave, we had Swatantrata Sangram, you know, we did a revolution for that. And that was done by each and every one of us. That is, anyone from any culture, any religion, any background, we small, big, or you can say men, women, everyone took part. Even the British tried for the divide and rule, because they know that we have Hindu Muslims and Hindu Muslim fight. If a Rajneta comes, a politician comes, he says people fight. But we didn't do that. Actually, something happened, let me tell you. Pakistan and Bangladesh, they were our brothers only. Because India was totally like this. But because of, Britishers, now we have Pakistan as a different country, Bangladesh as a different country. Previously, it was East and West Pakistan. So, everyone fought for the country. And this is what unity in diversity is. And everyone fought and they gave their life. How? I'll give you an example. This is Jallianwala Bagh massacre. This is in Amritsar. And General Dyer, he came. There was a very peaceful people who came here. And they were discussing about one of the very difficult. And when one law which was about to be passed and was being two of their leaders were detained because they were opposing this law. And they were just here. And General Dyer came and they just killed everyone here. You see, there was no place to live and they just started firing. So everyone, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, rich, poor, all gathered here and they were diverse, but they showed unity even for dying. The first Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, also in his book, he Bharat Ek Khoj, he has clearly written that this idea of unity has not just come like that. It is inside every Indian being. So it is Nehru who said that unity in diversity is the culture of this country. That is, anekta mein ekta. It was talked about the Indian flag also here. So let me tell you about Indian flag, because it is mentioned here. Indian flag is called as tricolor or tiranga. So we have, whenever we make a flag, it has to be in 2:3 ratio. That is, 3 should be the length and 2 should be the breadth, 2:3. And adopted on 22nd July 1947, 72 years ago. And we have 3 tribands here, saffron, white and Indian green. And this is having in the center, got from the Ashoka stump. And this has 24 spokes, lines. 24 spokes, and this was designed by Pingali Venkaya. So this is all about this chapter. Thank you so much and take care of yourself.